evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and we are back with a little bit more Zoo Tycoon 2. And today, we are gonna build the... Why is my Apatosaurus being stupid? That's not what we're building. No, you're in trouble, aren't you? Good. There you go. We are gonna build the Baryonyx exhibit, mainly so the person in my YouTube comment section stops telling me to build the bloody Baryonyx exhibit every 5 seconds. So, shush now. We're done. We're building the Baryonyx exhibit. Be happy, please. Thank you. Okay, so what I really wanted to do originally, I actually did an entire video on this earlier today, was I was gonna build the Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom tunnel system with the lava and stuff, but I couldn't find the mods to make it work. So, I wanted to do something original, and so I stole someone else's idea. Basically, I googled unique Zoo Tycoon 2 exhibits, and I'm going to approximately steal someone else's idea, but I've already kind of put my own little twist on it. I've got a few ideas that we're going to integrate. It's kind of this basic building shape where we can view our Baryonyxes both inside and outside, and I've also added like a little tunnel system here. So as the Baryonyx walks between the indoors and outdoor section, you'll actually be able to watch it happen. I'm really struggling to come up with original ideas at the moment, so use everyone else's, basically. So yeah, the Baryonyx is going to be living in here and out there, and you'll be able to watch it go boop, 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 and walk into this outdoor section at the same time, which I think is pretty cool. We do need to make this temperate grassland. Surprised me, Baryonyx, temperate grassland, but hey, that is the way of the world. Lovely stuff. Okay, so let's build a weird, weird building. And it is slightly weird, I'm not going to lie. That needs to come out to there. It's kind of like a free... I don't know how to describe the shape, but it's very much free-tiered. So we should be able to walk inside and view the Baryonyx. We should be able to go up a level and look down on our indoors Baryonyxes. And then we should be able to go up onto the roof and look down on our outdoor Baryonyxes, which you'll also be able to view from the path here. There's actually 4 ways of viewing the dinosaurs in this exhibit, which is pretty cool, I think. How far do I want that to go? This has to be a decent size. Make it 700. There we go, good stuff. And that needs to come in at an angle, like... No, I am changing things up a little bit here, but just enough. Okay. Ah, no, already I've messed up. Yeah, I'm going to pull it in by... 1. Sorry, guys. I'm trying to do it. I just want you guys to have something original to look at, you know, and like interesting buildings instead of the same old. Like the one I did before, it was literally a block with that looked a little bit like a terrible factory. If I still got the thing, I'll show you quickly what it looked like at some point at the end of this video. I'll give you guys a brief little glimpse. I'll keep my old content. But it just, I don't know, it wasn't working for me. I also put the darkness down, you know, that the gassy, darknessy stuff, which in theory is really cool, but in reality looks absolutely terrible. So, okay, there we go, that's better. Okay, so now what we need is a elevated path. Just don't know, there we go. It's all coming together. Okay, right, so I actually want that to go all the way across. Like so. So that is basically, the elevated path has formed the roof. Suddenly seeing problems with my design. Ah, no, I'm fine. I've got this. Got this in the bag. Faux show. So from that point, that's going to come down. And then this bit, you'll be able to look down into the Baryonyx exhibit from here. Now, you won't be able to see that from the outside, but you'll only see it when you walk inside. Okay, but we're not done yet. So, we need ourselves the fence. Now, where's my plaster fence at? I actually don't know if this is going to work. I'm kind of just putting it together and hoping for the best. Is 3 tall enough for humans? Yes, so that's going to go around there. Okay. I want this to kind of match the shape. Can I not put it? I can't put it there. That's a problem. Okay, think, Connor, think. Think. How have they done this? I actually can't figure it out. It's because I'm trying to add like an extra element that isn't there in their design, but I like my extra element and I'm pretty determined to make it work. So, what I need is to block this off so it looks like another building. And part of the idea is that you'll then be able to go a little bit higher up. How high do I need to go to match this? Is that it? No, need one more, right? So we need to go there. Okay, so then there'll be two of these. There. And that's flat. And then this comes along. Not like that, because that's stupid. In there. Can you see what I'm going for at all? I'm barely seeing what I'm going for these days. Oh, that's disastrous. No, we're going to make it work. Look, genius is always difficult. That's the way it is. Only problem I have is the lack of wall there. And I don't think I can add one. Or I can't think about that. It doesn't need one. Maybe I can get away with it. Just let me... Why won't you let me do that? Unless... Okay. That will let me do it, right? You're so close to being beautiful, and yet you're not. You're terrible. Why are you... Why... I hate so much about the way you are. Okay. Does that kill it? Yeah. No. There we go. It's just not quite worked out how I wanted it to. Not gonna pretend otherwise, guys. I'm gonna knock this in. Yeah. Okay, I mean, it's fine. It's fine. It's not. It's okay. Could be better. Doesn't look as good as their building, but that's because I have added this indoor viewing area, which if I got rid of, I could do a little bit more with. I just need to be able to add a fence then, I just can't do it. There's no way to do it. That's a really stupid design choice. Zoo Tycoon 2 developers, if for some reason you're watching this game now, let me put a fence here! There's no reason not to, and it's really frustrating. Wait, can I put a normal fence there? No, I can't, can I? It sits at the bottom automatically. Rah, rah, rah. Right. Ah, whatever. What's done is done. Is what it is. So we need an elevated path fence. Just a nice little glass one to sit. That'll do. Just a nice little glass one to sit here. So you can walk around and look. That's probably too big. I trust my people not to die. Well, I don't. They'll definitely all die, but that's fine. I don't really care. That's going to let you look down into the exhibit. Okay, it's fine. And we need to do the same up here at the top. Put a little glass. Okay, there we go. I thought the game just broke entirely then. And all the way around here. I don't really care if the people die, and they won't die. Like, even if they fall off the edge, they'll be fine. But I think just in terms of making it look moderately okay, you have to pretend that you care if your humans die, you know? I know you shouldn't lie. Wait, is this not even? This is... Oh, it's because that isn't even. Right, that's fine. It's fine. Panic not necessary. Okay, I need to get rid of that and that. Let's knock this down. Ciao! And then the path. My lovely little path goes in here. Okay! Making progress! Sort of. trust me when I say this is better than the other exhibit, anyway. The other exhibit was a disaster. Mainly because of the darkness. It's interesting. At the very least, it's interesting. I may have had to steal it, but it's interesting. I like it. It's growing on me. It looks silly, but it's just this bit that bugs me. But, hey, it kind of still works. Right, let's actually build... the exhibit itself, you know? So, dinosaurs. We have two choices of baryonyx. Well, we have one because I already know which one I'm going to use. So we have one choice of baryonyx. There's this one, which I downloaded, which... Oh, no, that's a good one. This is one I don't like that much. Eh, it's okay, but we're going to use this one because this one's pretty cool. It's kind of got that spooky vibe to it, you know, that you kind of want from a baryonyx. If I have one from the grasslands, clearly somebody's made this pack of grassland flowers because I've got tons of them, but I don't really like... any of them, unfortunately. They've all got this weird sort of AA problem where they're a little bit dark on the edges. And that one's okay. There we go. It's fine. It's fine. It doesn't have to be more than that. Baryonyx. Boop. Get a guy and a girl, just so we can have some babbies. And we need a fence. Put this somewhere with easy access. Stick it there. And we need a human. You always need a human. The zoo has become more famous. Huzzah! Come on, yep. Oh, wait, that's my fault. Okay. Should be done. Should be done. I quite like it. It's interesting. I'm going to add some plant life and stuff here, and we'll make it. I'll just do it now. Should look like the rest of the park, basically. Kind of grow my love for these kitty trees, whatever they're called. I think they're called kitty trees. Kylie trees, not kitty trees, you weirdo best in slot. If the kids want to play in the grass a little bit, they can do that. There is another type of tree, where is it? The kapok. Maybe we should put one of those in. Yeah, why not? Mix it up. Live a little. This is my version of YOLO, basically. Kapok trees. Kapok. Anything else? What's down here? We can always grab some stuff from this area. Windmill palm, yeah. Needs a little bit more colour, I think, down there. Let's grab some more flamingo lilies, which I seem to use a lot. That'll do. Doesn't have to be anything special. And we just need to change that over to tropical. Where are you? There you are. Just so it blends in with the rest of the zoo. This is better. I wanted to do original exhibits that aren't based necessarily on the films. That was always the plan, and I'm glad we've kind of done that. I really like that. I think that looks pretty baller. That's the kind of thing we're going to focus on more in the future. It's not really going to be about where the dinosaurs live. It's going to be about how we viewed the dinosaurs. And basically, I'm just going to keep stealing people's ideas. Because I'm not nearly creating enough, apparently, to come up with good ones on my own. I think this is all... As soon as you start to get a few buildings knocking around, it all comes together and looks a lot better. Like, just the zoo in general. Like, you look over to the right, you can see the hidden path down to the compies. I don't really love this area still. It still needs some work. Over the left, you see that, you know, big tall buildings really help with that. Of making it, hello, you're kind of cute. How you doing? Yeah, okay. You walk forward, you see the contours. You look to the right, you see, oh, I've had to shut this down, by the way. So, as in, get out. What? What's happened? What? Okay, there we go. Don't know what was going on there, but you keep getting stuck, don't you? There you go, you're thirsty. Have a pool. Basically, when I loaded the game up the first time today, there was like 8 park guests standing right here, because clearly they got off the gyrosphere and couldn't get back, like, out of the exhibit at all, so they just kind of wandered around the Apatosaurus exhibit, kind of freaking out a little bit. So I've had to shut it down until I figure out why that's happened. Anyways, but that's that. And you walk to the left, and there it is, looking kind of baller. All right, let's look at inside. Nothing there. Nothing. Tell you what, let's grab one of the berries. I want to view it from all the different angles. So there's our indoors. You're walking away, aren't you? Walk back in. Right there. Go. Wait. That damn tree. If you want it, you walk around here. You walk around here. I wish this was going the other way, but this is kind of the only way it makes sense. View from the outdoors. With the transition. Looks pretty cool over there. Let's go upstairs. Have a little look down. And then we go up here. I'll go over the edge. Maybe I can use a lower. I can't really use a lower, can I? Let's just jump. I think that's pretty cool. I'm actually really happy with that. Okay. Okay. And then we put that along there. Look, that's pretty cool. I really like it. I'm kind of proud of myself right now. I took someone else's really good design and I made it worse. We have so many different ways. This is actually a much better viewing point when they're actually out there, isn't it? It's just an interesting building. I really like that. I'm going to stop saying I like it though because I sound pretentious or self-obsessed. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, Baryonyx exhibit. That is kind of what we're aiming for with our future exhibits. This is the idea, to be honest, guys. This is the plan for future videos, you know, future exhibits. This is the kind of thing I'm going to be... You're stuck, aren't you? This is definitely the kind of thing I'm going to be aiming for. So, if you have ideas, things you'd like to see, or anyone else's exhibit style I can copy, you know, that would be helpful. Wait. Pause. I want to be here. As the Baryonyx walks across the transition. Kind of doing it a little bit weirdly. Cool. Okay, we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know what dinosaur you want to see in the next episode. That was our fourth exhibit. Might have to tighten things up a little bit room-wise because that was a big-ass exhibit. Might be okay. We don't necessarily have to do every dinosaur, but we're going to try. I might tighten up this area in the bottom right, like get rid of a lot of these trees and stuff and just turn that into a standalone, normal... I might just make this into an exhibit like all the others, to be honest. Because room-wise, it is going to be a problem otherwise. But we'll see. I also think it'll make it blend in nicer with the actual zoo itself. But let me know what you think in the comments. I'll see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers. Much love. As always. Bye-bye. Doesn't seem safe, does it? Small child. Baryonyx. Right, I think he's going inside. We need to go. We need to move. Well, I don't like the darkness. I wish it just didn't, I wish it wasn't gas. I wish it was just like a flat kind of thing, you know? But there's a tunnel. It sort of looks factory-esque. I built like a little elevator over there. I don't know, guys. I'm really limited in Zoo Tycoon 2. I'm doing what I... Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, please consider smashing that like button down below. It really helps me out. And also hitting the subscribe button if you want to be kept up to date with brand new videos about dinosaurs, animals, aliens, and everything else we do here on the Best of Slot channel. All of you who have subscribed so far, that's awesome. Make sure you hit that little bell icon. I'll highlight now. Otherwise, you may actually miss out on the content anyway because YouTube is silly. Thank you guys so much. Much love.